Select the proper preformed band clamp as per procedure 1001, preformed band clamp selection. Measure the hose outside diameter. The correct clamp will have an inside diameter no more than 1/4 inch larger than the hose OD just measured. Prepare and mark the hose for proper clamp placement as per procedure 1100, general preparation instructions. Proper clamp placement is vital to satisfactory assembly performance. If the hose has a helical wire and these wires are not being used for static grounding, trim the excess wire. When helical wire is present, ensure the clamp tails are pointing in the same direction as the helix, as shown here. Failure to do so could result in coupling slippage or ejection. Slide the clamps over the hose. Oversized clamps are used here for illustration purposes. Fully insert the coupling. Multiple attachment method couplings, like this one, can give the appearance of not being fully inserted. The fitting is properly inserted when the hose end contacts the coupling stop or no serrations are visible. Insert the clamp tail into the tool slot. Place the T-handle on a flat surface. Raise the lever and, with an open palm, push the lever down. Never push down on the lever with a closed fist. If the clamp tail suddenly breaks with a closed fist on the knob of the tool, the experience will be like punching a brick wall. Continue raising and lowering the tool lever. When the clamp is just about touching the hose, make sure the clamp is properly positioned to the mark on the hose. The clamp is properly tensioned when the OD of the clamp is even with or slightly below that of the hose. With the lever in the full down position, hold the tool with one hand and strike the tool punch with a soft-headed hammer or mallet several times. Using a claw hammer or ball peen hammer, which are case hardened, will shorten the tool life and could injure the operator if it shatters. With the lever in the fully closed position, grasp the tool in one hand, the hose in the other, and begin raising and lowering the punch tool to snap off the clamp tail. If sharp edges appear on the buckle, remove them with a file. Never strike the buckle with a hammer once the punch is set. This can cause the band to start slipping out from under the buckle. For multiple clamp installations, repeat the process, making sure the buckles are offset to prevent a leak path. For two clamps, as shown here, the buckles should be 180 degrees apart. For three clamps, the buckles should be 120 degrees apart. For four clamps, 90 degrees apart. Inspect the results using procedure 3002, band clamp inspection. Test the assembly to ensure proper coupling installation. Use procedure 4000, general hydrostatic testing, and procedure 4001, hydrostatic testing, to certify a quality assembly.
Dixon, the right connection.